In this tutorial, you will learn how to generate this four quadrant chart in Microsoft Excel. You can see here it has four quadrant, and I have used the data of effect of nitrogen on yield for this purpose. This column shows the location, second one shows the soil nitrogen percentage, and third shows the yield. So let's learn how to create this chart using this data. Firstly, select this data. I have selected only two columns. Go to Insert tab, and from here you can select scatter plot without line. Now resize it. Next, go to this plus sign and remove grid lines. And I want to insert axis titles, so I will check this option. Firstly, I will format chart title, put equal sign in formula bar, and select the cell, click enter, go to home and format it black, bold, and change its font size to 20. Now select y-axis label and put equal sign, and it shows the yield in kg. I will select this cell and press enter. Black color, bold, 14 size. Similarly, I will use format painter option to format this one, and here I will put equal sign and select soil nitrogen cell, press enter. You can see here this one is inserted here. Now select this axis, right click, go to format axis option here, click on it. From here you can adjust the minimum and maximum value and the unit between these. It is currently selected from 0 minimum and maximum 10, that's fine. Measure unit 1, I will change it to 2. Now you can observe that the measure unit is changed now. Select again, and I want bold with black color and font size 12. And so I will change their color to red one. If you scroll down, you will find the option of horizontal axis cross. Automatic, select this one, axis values, and I will select the half value, which is 5, half value of that axis. Go to fill and line option, and from here select solid fill, solid line. Red color is fine, and change its width to 1.5. Now go to this option again, and from here you can select tick marks. I will select only measure type and outside. Now you can see here that it crosses this axis on the 5 values. Similarly, select other axis, and here maximum value is 9. I will change it to 10. Measure unit, change it to 2. And from here you will find the option of vertical axis, crosses. I will select axis value, and I want that this cross at 5, at middle of this axis. So I will select here 5. Now go to fill and line option, and you can change its color of the line and its width. And you can insert the tick marks using this option, as I earlier explained. I will insert only measure type tick marks. Now you can observe that these labels are crossed at 5 values. Now select these labels and use format painter option and click on this axis. It will automatically format like this one. Now click here. You can see here a line appeared here. Go to design option, sorry, format option, and here you will find the option of shape outline. Select black color and again click on it. Go to weight and select 1.5 pt. Now I will format these markers. Select these markers. You can see whole data series is selected. Right click. Go to format data series. Now go to fill and line option by using this bucket. Here you will find two options, line and marker. Click on marker and again go to this marker option. Select built-in. You can change the type of marker. I will keep this one and I will change its size to 7, 8, 9. Scroll down. And here you will find the option of solid fill, and I will select this color. That's fine. And in border I don't want any line, so I will select no line. Now you can see here that the markers is changed now, and their shape and their size is changed. Again select this one. Now I want to insert data labels. Click on plus sign and here you will find the option of data labels. Check on it. Now select these data labels. Right click. Go to format data label option and from here check this option values from cell. This dialog box appear. You can select this column and click on OK. Now the location is displayed here, but there is also values along with them, so I will uncheck while values. Now only location is displayed here. Go to home tab, bold black color and 12. Now you can also change the location of this. Currently it is selected above. You can select either center, left or right. If you even change the location of this one, double click on it and you can even place it here. If you single click on, then all will be selected. Double click any of them and you can drag it at any position. So thanks for watching this tutorial. Good